Quincy students are on cue. Let's take a look at our on cue students of the week. Wanna be the best, but at what cost? If you're gonna stay here, nothing's ever changing. No big world, gotta see it all. Gotta get up even when you fall. There's no point in waiting. Hi friends! Do you remember back a few weeks ago on our last weekly announcements when we were talking about the zones of regulation? Well, this amazing person named Leah Kuypers, she came up with a way to kind of categorize how we're feeling, which helps us understand our feelings better and helps us decide, if we don't like the way we're feeling, what can we do to feel differently? So let's review those zones of regulation again. So first, the blue zone. We're in the blue zone when we're sad or bored or tired or feeling sick. Not an ideal zone to be in when we're at school, is it? But it's a great zone to be in when we're about to go to bed. As long as we're not sad, right? But if we're tired, that's a great zone to be in. The next zone is the green zone. And when we're in the green zone, we're happy, focused, calm, and proud. Now, that sounds pretty awesome, doesn't it? Sounds like a great zone to be in for learning when we're at school. Next, it's the yellow zone. We're in the yellow zone when we're worried, frustrated, feeling silly, or feeling excited. Now, some of those words don't sound so fun, but being silly and excited, that's pretty fun. We all want to be silly and excited sometimes, right? The last zone is the red zone, and we're feeling overjoyed or elated or panicked, angry, or terrified when we're in the red zone. I mean, it sounds pretty awesome to be overjoyed and elated, right? And we'd like that to happen once in a while. It sounds a little scary to think about feeling panicked, angry, or terrified. So we probably don't want to spend a ton of time in the red zone, but the red zone is an important part of our life. So here's the deal, my friends. There are no good zones or bad zones. We're going to spend time in each of the zones. We just have to figure out what's the best zone for me right now with what I want to accomplish. And then if we're not in that best zone, we can take some steps to get into a different zone. It's interesting to think of the zones like traffic signs. When given a green light or in the green zone, one is good to go. A yellow sign means to be aware or take caution. And a red light or stop sign means stop. And when one is in the red zone, that's often the case. The blue zone can be compared to the rest area signs where someone goes to rest or re-energize. So if you're feeling tired in the blue zone and it's time for learning, you might want to do an activity or use a strategy that would help you get energized and focused. Or if you're feeling panicked and you're in the red zone and you're in a situation where it'd be really good to be calm, you might want to do a calming activity like deep breathing. So understanding what zone we're in and what zone we want to be in can help us take action.
Hi kids! Our book of the week this week is Seas Behind Trees, and it's by Michael Doris, one of my favorites. It's a fiction book, and because it's new to our library here, it's new to the queue, you'll find it up on top of this shelf for a little while we enjoy the new books. This is a wonderful story about a boy named Walnut, and he's part of a Native American tribe. And one of the customs in the tribe is that when the boys get to a certain age, they get to prove their skills and prove their worthiness to the tribe, and they get to become adults and get their new name. Well, Seas Behind Trees is a little different, and he doesn't have the same skills that the other boys in the tribe have, so he gets a little bit nervous about this. This is a beautiful story about discovering what he's good at and how it can be useful to the tribe. And Seas Behind Trees and the adults in the tribe discover that he has a gift that no one else has, and he can do the impossible for them. And then he gets to go on an adventure with one of the older members of the tribe and do something that no one else is able to do. Check it out. You'll love it.
Okay, friends. Let's say this all together today. because Quincy is a Be Nice school. Are you ready? Say it with me. I pledge to notice what is good, what is right, and when someone needs a friend. I pledge to invite myself to reach out and to make a new friend. I pledge to challenge others, to be kind, respectful, and civil. I pledge to empower others through my support, my words, and my friendship. I pledge to be nice. Thank you.
At this time, would you please stand, push in your chair, put your right hand on your heart, and say the Pledge of Allegiance.
Have the best week ever, Quincy.